Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. For today's video, I thought I would try something a little bit new and create a video talking about design tips to help you sell more designs on Redbubble. Thought I'd introduce myself just in case you're new here. Hi, my name is Katie, and on my channel I talk about my own print-on-demand journey so that I can share all the tips and tricks that I am learning with you to make your print-on-demand journey just a little bit easier. Alright, without any further ado, let's dive right into the video. So throughout my video series where I review my subscribers' Redbubble shops, I have come across a wonderfully wide variety of different sorts of designs, from, you know, simple text designs to nice illustrations or a combination of the two. And, you know, I do kind of notice a trend when I'm reviewing that there are specific kinds of designs that are more likely to sell than others. So I thought maybe I could do a series where I give some design tips. Now you may be wondering, well, how are you qualified to, you know, give actual design tips? Well, I am an artist and an illustrator, and I have taken many courses in college actually on graphic design and am rather familiar with color theory and, you know, things of that nature. So I thought maybe if I could share some of those tips, then it might also help some of you, especially those who are just starting out with their print-on-demand journey, to hopefully help you with creating those designs. Because the most important part of actually making sales on Redbubble or any print-on-demand platform is going to be the design itself. Basically, the rest of the things you can do are more cosmetic for the most part. I mean, other than the design, the main thing that you need to worry about is the tags for the design, but, you know, other than those two big main things, the rest of it is just kind of cosmetic. Helps everything look nice, may help with you know, page rankings, search engine rankings, things like that. But if the design itself isn't so great, then you may have trouble selling that design on various products. So for today, I thought we would talk a little bit about color theory and, of course, how that actually applies to making and selling designs. So as hopefully you are aware, there are several colors that look very well together and several that do not. And the brightness, the tone, the contrast of these colors can significantly impact the appeal of a design, let's say. Knowing which colors match well with other colors is definitely a skill that can take some time to develop. So in order to kind of speed up that process, I suppose, I thought I would share with you this great tool that you can use to come up with sets of colors that do in fact go together and match. And a quick rule of thumb is that generally, unless the design specifically depends upon it, selecting neon type colors is usually not the best way to go. And unless you are going for a very unique sort of neon aesthetic, picking neon colors that are naturally opposites is also not such a good idea. The main primary colors all have an opposite, and when you mix those two opposite colors together, you get brown. So the two opposite colors will look very vibrant and bright next to each other. And this is often a strategy used for branding specific sports teams, logos, things like that. So a good example of this is going to be bright yellow and bright purple. Now we see this example with the Lakers team. It's very eye-catching color combination. The stark contrast between the two really helps the jerseys stand out and becomes, you know, quite an iconic duo, especially when paired with their specific logo. So this is an example of contrasting colors. Another example would be red and green. Mix these two colors together, you get brown, as well as blue and orange. Same result. They can look very good together, and if you have a design that features a lot of orange, then a muted blue perhaps would be a good option to really help that design stand out from the background. But having these two colors paired together at the exact same tone of brightness can be a little jarring to the artistic sensibilities. So that is why it is generally a good idea to not. And as I'm sure many of you are in fact aware, lately the trend has been more minimalistic, muted pastels, muted warm tones often, especially with all the cottage core aesthetics going around here. So picking neon colors is not always the best route to go with, unless of course you are specifically creating neon designs and have that specific aesthetic going on. But if you are just starting out, then it might be a good idea to be a little bit more selective with the colors that you're using for your designs. So without any further ado, let's dive on into my screen and take a look at this great tool that you can use in order to help you select colors that will complement each other and hopefully help you sell more designs.
Right, so the wonderful tool that you can use to help you select colors that pair well together is called the Adobe Color Wheel. If you type into Google Adobe Color Palette, then the first result is going to be the one that we want. So I'll go ahead and click on that. And here is this super helpful tool. So it's showing the standard color wheel that you are going to see with most design softwares, including the Adobe Creative Suite. And what's super helpful is that based on the setting that you select, you can get a wonderful range of colors that will go very well together for whatever design you are using. And it also gives you the hex code, as you can see underneath the swatches or the squares of color at the bottom here, that you can simply copy and paste into whatever design software you are using. So all you have to do is you can simply change the setup of these selection tools as you see fit in order to come up with colors that will hopefully look good together in whatever design you are working on. And it is very fun to go ahead and play around with all of these different settings and see what sorts of color combinations you can come up with. Here is a little bit of what I was mentioning before. These are complementary colors. So the color opposite a color on the color wheel is going to be a complementary color. So if you look, you can see that orange is directly opposite of blue. And when mixed together, these two colors create brown. If I move this around, you'll see that red and green are also opposites on the color wheel and make brown when mixed together. Moving along, purple and yellow are opposite on the color wheel as well, and certainly pop when next to each other. You can also adjust the brightness and the tone as well if you are looking more for pastels or perhaps a more muted or vibrant color palette. It's all up to you. Here I am playing around a bit more with some of the following options for different kinds of color combinations that you can do, just to give you an idea of all the different options and the kinds of things that you can do with them. There are tons of different varieties that you can come up with, so it's also really fun to just play around. It might even give you an idea for a new design to work on. And if you do happen to have an account with the Adobe Creative Suite, then You can also save these different color palettes. So instead of having to write down all of the hex codes each and every time you come up with a new color combination that you like, you can go ahead and simply hit the save button off to the right over here. And then you can revisit these color palettes whenever you feel like it. I suppose the proper way that Adobe likes to put it is color harmony. The color rule ensures a harmonic balance of colors based on the color you have set as a base. So go ahead and check out this website, give it a try for yourself. I have definitely found it very helpful, especially when I need a little bit of help coming up with colors that will work well together to achieve the goal I want for a specific design. So have tons of fun playing around with this wonderful free tool. You don't have to have an account with Adobe in order to use this tool. It is free for everyone and extremely helpful. So good luck with your designing.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found the video helpful. And if you did, please don't forget to smash the like button and subscribe for more content just like this. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.